I went to see the movie Splice today. Now, I'd read some of the reviews. Rotten Tomatoes had it nearly 75%, so I thought, that's not bad. Read a few of the reviews. I don't like to read reviews before I go to movies. To begin with, I don't want to know anything about a movie before I go to see it. I certainly don't want to know how it ends or anything like that. And there's a lot of critics out there that I just don't pay any attention to, because I like the kind of movies that I like, and I go to watch those kind of movies. And I go to the movie theater to be entertained. I go to suspend disbelief, sit back, and enjoy the ride. And if it's a halfway decent ride, then I'm okay with that. And they can take me wherever the hell they want to take me, you know? I mean, that's what movies are all about. So I try not to get too critical. So just from the movie perspective, I would call it a sci-fi movie. It's definitely rated R. There's a lot of sexuality in it. Language, I didn't hear any bad language, but there's a lot of sexual overtones to it, and a few sex scenes. So that is a consideration if you're taking a younger person to see that movie. It's not really appropriate for younger people, probably. Just based on that. So, from a science fiction movie with the basic premise of somebody's doing something with gene splicing, I mean, that's pretty apparent from the title and from the previews. Somebody's done something. Now, how they did it, why they did it, these are questions that you get answered when you watch the movie. But at another level, there is the question that is constantly in the back of your mind, not the how did they do this, or even why did they do this, but really, should they have done this at all? And I think that's a question that we're going to have to deal with a lot sooner than a lot of people think. I think that gene splicing and what we do with gene splicing today has some real ethical questionable boundaries that we're kind of pushing against today. The idea of using human DNA and doing some gene splicing along the way with some human components, this is not far down the road if it's not already being done. And I think, from my perspective, the movie worked from the perspective of being a good science fiction movie with a credible storyline. It got a little weird in the second half of the movie. I kind of understand why they went in that direction, although I think it would have been more credible as a movie if they hadn't quite taken that divergent path. I think that was a little over the top, but it's again within the realm of possibility, plausibility, I guess, when you're dealing with this kind of a situation. It's easy to see that something like that could occur. People have lots of motives for doing what they do in terms of scientific discovery, and some of those motives are okay, and some of those motives are not okay. And that's why it's such a big ethical question about, should we be doing this thing at all? So I think from an entertainment value, if you just like science fiction movies with a pretty good cast, pretty good list of action scenes, a few twists and turns, a little bit of blood and gore, you know, it's got all the components. Sex, it's got all the components to make a good science fiction, you know, alien type movie. It's not quite like that, but I mean, it has many of those elements that, you know, you're kind of at the edge of your seat at a few places, kind of wondering what's going to happen next. But I also think that it worked at least for me, because I was thinking about this all during the movie and afterwards and have since, the ethical question of, is this something that we should be doing? Is this something that we should even be thinking about doing? And do we have any idea of what the consequences are if we go that step, if we do that? Do we have any clue? It raises all those questions that, you know, you grow up, I grew up reading Heinlein and Clark and people that talked about sentient human being and whether a robot was sentient or not, and what did it take for a robot to become a citizen and to have the same rights and privileges as a citizen, and, you know, all of those ethical questions that come into play when you think about creating something. You know, you take a human embryo and a human sperm, you know, human components, right? You've got all the human components, and you create another human, and it gets implanted and grows. Test tube baby type concept, right? Okay, we're pretty clear on where the boundaries are there. We're pretty clear on what that means. But if we were to create something that's not really human, what then? And what do we do with that? So I think, for me, the movie worked on just being a good science fiction movie level. Obviously left it open for another movie. I think this could be one of those movies that you're probably better off not doing a sequel to it. Just leave it alone. Do it. You know, you've done it. Just leave it there. But I'm sure that they'll try and milk as much as they can out of this movie. But so it worked as a science fiction movie. And then it worked for me on the intellectual level of asking some of those ethical questions about when is it okay? Is it okay? And what are some of the parameters, the ethical parameters surrounding this whole business of creating something that's not quite human? So, all in all, I would say if you've been thinking about going to see it, if you're a science fiction movie fan, you like science fiction movies, you like this genre movie, you'll enjoy the movie. It's a good movie in that respect. It isn't quite at the intellectual level of diving into and really addressing or really talking about, discussing the ethical issues, but they're all kind of undercurrents as you go through the movie. The undercurrents are there the whole time. So if you're thinking about that at all, it can be part of the movie experience. Anyhow, I thought it was a good movie. I thought it worked, and I thought it was well worth going to see in the theater. So, that's my review of Splice. A Splice of Life, so to speak. Talk to y'all soon.